Vic really didn't want to go inside the delivery room.
Sabi, babe, mahingi na ako dyan.
Kasi takot na takot siya talaga. Nagulat ako, pumasok lang siya. He took a video of everything. I think I'm one of the few women who didn't go through that lihi state. Though I was very sensitive with smell ng garlic, onions, and actually any strong smell. It really made me dizzy. But also, hindi rin ako dumaan sa stage ng nausea or yung pagsuka. The part that was really affected was my skin. Nag-breakout talaga ako during that time. But parang yun lang, I actually had an easy pregnancy. We had dinner at the fort with all of Vic's children. We were actually talking about it pa. Sabi ko, paano mo malalaman kung nagli-labor ka na? That was the topic the entire night. How would you know kung kailangan mo na pumunta sa hospital? Kasi as early as around 5.5 months, I was already contracting. So, by the time na tumutong ako ng 7-8 months, sanay na ako dun sa feeling na yun. So that night, we went home, siguro mga 12 a.m. Parang I felt, I was contracting, but that was very normal for me. And then I felt na parang semi-dysmenorrhea kind of pain. It wasn't painful, but it was just different. I realized na parang nakakatatlong wiwi na pala ako, na parang color brown. And then nung na-feel ko yun, sabi ko, shocks, baka blood. So I called up my doctor, I said, should I go to the hospital? Sabi niya, yeah, you should come now. I didn't have a baby bag because I was just 35 weeks. So on our way to the hospital, sabi niya, i-time mo yung interval ng contractions. I was having contractions every 2 minutes, 1 minute. So dinikitan ako ng monitor. Nagpe-preterm labor na pala ako. So sabi ng doctor ko, you're contracting but you cannot give birth now because the lungs might not be matured or hindi pa siya talaga nag-work ng maayos. Sabi niya, I'm gonna give you a booster shot. 2 doses to. You take one now and then you take one after 24 hours. If you have to give birth, then you can give birth. Sabi niya, but now we'll give you meds via IV to control the contraction. Sabi kasi, kung mawala na yung contractions mo, you can go home. So that was around 3 a.m. ng Sunday na, November 5. So the entire day, andun lang ako. Okay naman, I went up to the room after a while. The problem is, the meds gave me really bad palpitations. Pero yun talaga ang effect para mag-stop yung contractions. Sinabi naman nila yun dun sa very start. So around mga 9 p.m., I asked for a medicine that could counter the palpitations. Sabi nung doctor, lagyan ka ulit namin ng monitor. Baka naman mawala na. So we went down. It was around 1 a.m. And then I fell asleep. And then when I woke up, yung doctor tumakbo palabas. Tapos may 2 female doctors na pumasok sa loob. She opened my legs. Tapos she pushed the baby in. Because apparently, her heart rate dropped to 70. Her heart rate is 150. Nang normal. It dropped to 70 because she was trying to come out na. 1 cm pa lang ako. My placenta matured early. My placenta started to mature at 32 weeks or 33. Sobrang sakto naman that time, nag-detach yung placenta ko. And then she was coming out. Tapos nasusuffocate na siya. They had to push her back in. It was like a solid 8 minutes. I was just shaking. Parang my body was just shaking. I had no pain. The whole time. Nagsishake yung body ko, but I didn't feel any pain. And then after that, they decided to open me up. Kasi they can't take a risk na mangyari to another time na wala akong monitor, we wouldn't know. 15 minutes after, C-section na. She came out at 3:15 a.m. November 6. Hindi ko pa siya nakikita, narinig ko pa lang yung voice niya. Umiiyak na talaga ako. Luckily, she was 6.9 pounds. More than average na yun. For a full-term baby, malaki siyang bata. So, they didn't need to put her in an incubator. The day before, they didn't make me eat so much. Kasi in case nga daw na manganak ako. The only problem was, her sugar was 0. Minutes pa lang siya, nilagyan na siya ng IV. Kawawa. You know what? On the second day, I was walking. They took out my pain meds. And they said, walk. So I walked. It was kind of painful. Sabi nila, para daw mas mabilis yung recovery. you have to walk right away. Or at least stand. So yung una nga, hindi mo talaga maangat yung head mo. I went home the fourth day. I had no pain na. They actually gave me pa meds for pain. Hindi ko na siya nainom. Hindi ko pinagsisisihan at tumayo ako agad on the second day. Kasi I think that really helped. Saturday, before our dinner, Ruby brought me to this church. She said it was a miraculous church. It's called Sabsaban in Carmona, Cavite. It only opens once a month. The mass was 3 hours long in Latin. Meron ka lang booklet para maintindihan mo kung nasa na. You were there. I prayed for an easy, fast, and painless delivery. The next day, I gave birth. Ang bilis talaga. And it was really painless. And it was fast. And it was easy. I really cried. Kasi I've been wanting this for so long. It's all worth it.